When summer is finally forgotten, as daylight dwindles sooner each day, look around the corner, just beyond Main Street. Chances are, there's a game in a backyard. Children in the midst of imagining. Some with a notion, innocent but powerful. You eagerly followed your team, listening to that distant voice. You couldn't sleep after a victory. Couldn't wait till the day when it might be your time. And then that day arrived. That moment, that affirmation, when you were told you were special. And so you worked and you sacrificed, pointing toward that day in the fall when all of America would be watching you, watching your team. The kind of day dreamed of in a backyard just around the corner from Main Street. Questions confronting number one Florida State. Are these to be the Seminoles who will at last run the full gauntlet of grueling competition and withering expectations? Is he to be Florida State's first Heisman winner? Is he to be, finally, a national champion? But between these hopes and their fulfillment, there is the myth, the stadium in South Bend, and history's team, Notre Dame.
Here come the Irish, 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 here come the Irish.
11 national titles, 7 Heisman trophies. No other school has won as many championships. No other school has had as many All-Americans. And in their home, you also play against their past. Galloping shadows from 1924. Echoes of legendary coaches. In South Bend, they've become accustomed to teams chasing championships. And now comes another, inspired by a tradition without equal. So here we are, perfect seasons at stake, a game in a perfect place, a collision for history. A school hoping to finally ascend to college football's summit. A school hoping to add to its already abundant legend. Number one Florida State and number two Notre Dame. The coming of a day dreamed of in backyards just around the corner from Main Street.
I think that going around and visiting them last night and talking to them, I think they realize that if we play well, we're going to win, and if we don't play well, we don't have a chance, and it's up to us to perform well. And you can't perform well if you're afraid or if you're nervous about making a mistake. This is the time just to go out there and put on a show. I think turnover is going to be a critical key, and I think this wind is certainly going to give us a greater challenge in our kicking game than previously.
The wind may be one.
Well, we feel like we've had one already with the University of Miami, and if we win this one, there'll be some more, you know.
Does this one feel different, though?
Does it feel different? A little bit. I mean, you know, at least when we played Miami, it was in Tallahassee, and we knew we had them in our backyard. And the big difference is now we go to somebody else's backyard and try to do the same thing.
Not just any somebody else.
No.
It's South Bend.
No, that's
exactly
right.
And it makes a difference, right?
Well, it really does. It does to me. I think it means more difference to me than it does my players. My players are so young, they don't know about all that tradition, to be honest with you. You have to remember, some of these boys were raised in orange groves. Some of these boys were raised on farms. Some of these boys were raised in the country. They don't know about all that tradition. But I did tell them about the tradition of Notre Dame. I want them to know it. They ought to know it. I mean, if you're a football player and you have you want football, you need to know about Notre Dame.
At least 35 scholarship players are going to be watching the game from the stand. So if any of you has any fantasies about running out of that stadium tunnel with your gold helmet shining in the sun, you best leave them right here.
No, I did not take them to see Rudy. And the only reason, we hadn't been around where it was yet.
But you actually would have?
Oh, I'd love for them to see it. It'd be too difficult for us to get 100 boys to take them to the picture show. We've done that before, however, but I would love for them to see it.
If the game is close, he was quoted, he changed his mind on this, but now he says, I'll go for two for the victory. What would you do?
You know, back when they used to have the deals where they get guns and shoot each other because you said something bad about their wife.
Aaron Burr and Alexander Hamilton.
Exactly.
That's what you're thinking
of. Well, I'm kind of like, it's hard to back down from that win. You know, I don't know if, again, I don't know if I can, I don't know if I can go for one. Maybe it might be the thing to do. I don't know if I can go for one.
Dating 287, you're 73-9. Never lower than fourth in the polls. Second a couple of times. But you know the story. No national title. You don't need a national title to prove you're a great coach. But do you need it to complete your portfolio for personal satisfaction?
Oh, yeah. If I were to die today or tomorrow or quit coaching, my resume would have something missing. There'd be something big missing on it, and it's a national championship. You know, I might not ever get that thing, you know. And I can't carry with me if I do get it. But I sure, you naturally, I'd like for Florida State University, I'd like for the coaches at Florida State, I'd like for the players at Florida State to have a national championship. No, there's no doubt about it. It's missing on my resume.
What do you like the night before a game like this, or in the moments on the sideline before they kick off in a game like this? Are you feeling something noticeably different?
Oh, you get very competitive. You get very competitive. You just get, you don't care. I mean, I'll be concerned about this and concerned about this and that. And just, you really just concerned, are you ready? And then you walk out on that field and you start getting lined up. Boy, then all of a sudden the juices start flowing and you're ready to strike anything that wiggles. You lose complete fear of anything else, you know? And I can see it in Lou Holtz's eyes on the other side. It's just, I think all of us coaches kind of gear up for that. And it's kind of like when you get out on that field, y'all got to leave me alone now. I'm busy, you know. It's all football.
Third down and 8. McDougal to throw. A little swing right side. It is behind Becton. Becton has the room. The 45, the 50. He is to the 41-yard line. A Florida down and 7. Four-man rush for the Irish. And Ward breaks it clean across the 30. He has the
2 seconds per pass play.
And the fast break offense is exactly a year and a week old. Pressure from the backside. Charlie Ward nicely moves inside out. Picks up a block. Another good break. Has the first down. Hitting stadium. Charlie Ward, by the way, is 3 of 3. And this one is over the middle. He is now 4 of 4. Matt Pryor for a drive that has been clear sailing.
Here it comes.
Pass complete, right side, touchdown, Kevin Knox. Ray Zeller's the first back three. He pops open.
Wow.
And the offensive line of Notre Dame. Wide to the near side. The tight end is Oscar McBride. He is split open. We're looking at a reverse on the pitch. It is Jarrell has three blockers in front to the 20. He's going to score. He does.
And the receivers already have 32 yards after the catch.
Ward to throw. Over the middle and the coverage pass is complete. And this is tomorrow. And now to the I formation. And William Floyd is in as the fullback. Charlie throws out. With a spin outside by Pryor down the sideline. And he is bumped out of the 36-yard line. First down. We're tied at 7. Lee Becton. Becton, head fake outside. Comes back inside. First down. Play action fake and deep over the middle. This pass is complete to Clint Johnson. First down, get down and 6. Becton, he is clear. 15-10-5, touchdown.
If they can force Notre Dame to kick a field goal, that can shift the momentum.
Third and long, play action. Here is the throw. It is caught. First down. In offense. To Jeff Burr. Burr into the end zone, touchdown. The pitch is to Becton. He's around the corner, cuts to the outside at the 50. Close to the point, and Sean Jackson are the running backs along with Charlie Ward. He is in the gun. Play action fake, throws, has a man wide open. It's Kez McCarvey. And McCarvey across the 30-foot triangle, a slip right. Second down and 13. Charlie Ward, he's going to run with it. And he goes sliding just out of doubt. Leverage play of the drive. And here's a little swing. Left side here is done again. He dives for it, and he's got it. Touchdown, Florida State.
I'm going to say it again. I don't know who.
Second down and 8, we're going to throw. Here's the quick out. Miller, touchback, 45-50. 48-yard line of his package.
Coming with the blitz, corner blitz.
Pass, Dawson, holds on, first. I apologize, I'm sorry.
That's all right.
Play action fake, option, here's the pitch. It is Beckett around the corner, 20, and then pulled down from behind. It's Paul Fela. Is the quarterback and the full house backfield. They have scored in the ball game off of this alignment, and they're going to do it again. Same man, Jeff Burrows. Four-man rush, running room up the middle, and Charlie slides across. Has pressure, rolls to the near side. There's a flag down. Ward carries, he's going to step out of bounds at around.
This isn't hard, you rush three and backpedal everybody else into the end zone.
Tipped, caught, touchdown!
Oh my goodness!
Kez McCarvey!
Oh my! With apologies to Dick Enberg, oh my! Think of it.
Florida State at their own 37-yard line, 51 seconds left. Flag is down. Charlie Ward scrambles, he is up into the middle, laterals on. Kez McCarvey.
That's Charlie.
He's got to get out of bounds, and he does.
And then give himself a chance with two shots in the end zone.
Deep over the middle. It is caught.
Coach, you've been involved in some games in your day. Where does this one compare?
This was just a great football game. I compliment Florida State, Charlie Ward. They refused to quit. Our players didn't either. It's one game, and I think lived up to all the hype.
Lived up to all the hype, those moments at the end.
Thank you. Good luck, my team.
Sportsman, those moments at the end, what were you thinking? What were you feeling?
Well, all you can do is stay focused. You know you're going to be in this type of game. They are every bit as good as I thought. We played well. We're happy to win.
You know, I sense going in that this game would mean respect for you, that maybe people weren't thinking this was a real good team. Tell me.
I think the last couple of days, I said we were going to play pretty well, and then we felt we belonged here. Florida State's every bit as good as I thought. Our players really competed.
How did you know you were going to play this well against a fine Florida State team?
You could just sense it in practice, the game plan coming together.